Did you know that you can email directly from a record inside of SmartSuite? I'm talking about not leaving the native SmartSuite environment and writing an email inside of the SmartSuite environment itself and sending it to somebody. I can't wait to explore this new feature. It is groundbreaking and currently in alpha testing. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools in 2023. It is full of endless possibilities, and I'm really excited to be talking about this particular topic because, I'll be honest with you, I have not even explored it yet myself. I just learned that it was put out in alpha testing, and I can't wait to roll up my sleeves and take a look at how it works. Now, that being said, before we get going, I want to invite you to follow along with me. I will be including my SmartSuite link below this video. If you don't already have a SmartSuite account, consider signing up with that link. Two reasons you might want to do so. Number one, it's going to be a great way for you to say, hey, thanks Gareth for that video that I found super helpful, and it's going to show some love back to the channel. Number two, in order to help encourage you to sign up with that link, you can apply for your exclusive swag if you upgrade to a paid plan in the future. So don't miss out on that. Grab our link below and let's just hop on into this amazing new feature. I can't wait to check it out. So first and foremost, what we're going to be doing is emailing information directly from SmartSuite. So let's first take a look here. What I have is some fake data in this example inside of my SmartSuite solution. Now, if you are not familiar with SmartSuite, you probably don't know that I can connect to anything that's in SmartSuite anywhere. So if I were to look at my clients, here I have example person from test company. Well, when I open this up, you see how it's red here, or burgundy, I don't know what you call that, but whatever that color is, it's different than the teal color that is represented here inside of our pre-existing solution. And that's because this information, this contact information, lives somewhere completely different. It's in a totally different SmartSuite solution, but I can access it just with a click because I have a linked relationship between my two different applications in SmartSuite. This one is my hourly consulting, that my teal one, and it's linked up here to my clients or my contact information in a totally different application. So all this data here lives inside of the contact information in a different place. And the most important part is going to be that email address for this client. Now, for testing purposes, I always recommend using your own email address just to make sure that you're not spamming somebody with some automated email stuff. So I have my own email address in here, and we're going to take this out for a test. Now, I've also denoted the consultant here and a date. And you know, the idea is that this application is recording a specific consultation that had a specific date and time and was held between a consultant and a client. So let's say that I wanted to come in and message this client. Well, the old way would be I would have to come in, open up the client record, pull out the client's email address, copy that, open up my email application, and paste that email address into the email, and then compose my message. But the unfortunate part is then I lose the traceability of that email, and it's not necessarily connected to the piece of information that it was relevant to. Maybe what I want to do is send an email as part of a lead flow or as follow-up on this particular consultation. Well, how cool is it that I can now do that directly from SmartSuite? So step one, click on opening the record. Once we're inside of here, you'll get access to the comment section. Let's go ahead and open that up. And what this is now called is the communication center. And this is where all communication inside of SmartSuite will exist for any record. So again, it's important to note that this is specific to a solution, an application, and most granularly, specific to a record inside of that application. So all of this communication is happening at the record level inside of this particular record. Now, in order to gain access to the email section, click on this settings up here on the header, and we'll come on down to emails. And as I said, currently in alpha for all SmartSuite users. I can toggle this on, but before doing so, let's figure out what we're getting into. We are going to be sending and receiving emails without leaving SmartSuite. Communicate with people outside of your workspace from any email address you already have, Are you kidding me? I'm so excited. This is so new that the Learn More button isn't even linked up to something yet. So this is literally cutting edge. Let's go ahead and click on that toggle and enable this. Now, I have it on good authority that it may come in the future that this is automatically enabled. SmartSuite is kind of testing this out to see if this is something that we want or we don't want as users. My personal thought is that it's better to be coming in by default as off and allow me to turn it on when I want to. So it's now turned on. What does that mean? Can I send an email to somebody? How can I send it? Now that it's toggled on, I have the email section inside of the communication center. Amazing. I can have a conversation with my team about this record. I can at mention people, add comments, give a status, post a screenshot. So it looks like maybe I can't send this externally and it has to be internal. As I said, I'm figuring this out as I go. So let's see. So let's go ahead and say new email. I'm still natively inside of SmartSuite. Who am I sending to? I can hit a drop down here. I have no email fields yet in my record, so I better fix that. Let's get an email field in here. So thankfully I already have this information. It's in a lookup field because it lives in the client record. So let's look at that client relationship and let's bring in that email field. Let's go ahead and add that in. And what you're gonna see here is the client email. Remember, always test with your own email address. So maybe we have better luck now. Let's go back into that. And I'm gonna go back into my comment section, back to my emails, and let's try again. Still no email address yet available inside of this record. This could be a glitch because we're in alpha, or it could be that because we've looked it up, it's not necessarily reading it correctly just yet. So let's go ahead and exit one more time, and I'm just gonna hard code an email address in here for testing purposes. Let's go ahead and bring this in, and I'm just gonna put my email address in there, just copy paste, see if that makes any difference whatsoever. I noticed that when I'm clicking over this one, it treats it a little bit differently than the lookup field. You'll notice that it doesn't highlight it the same way that it does here. So that might be an indication that they're slightly different inside of SmartSuite. Maybe this will be upgraded or changed over time, but for now, looks like we might need to hard code that email in. Let's give it another shot though. Expand that record back to comments. Let's go on to new email. Oh, I could click it right there from the all section. I love that. In the past, I'd been going over to the email panel and starting from there, but it looks like I can just, boom, add new email right here. Do I have access now? Yes, I can access the email fields inside of the record, so I can just bring them in right there, and let's say email test from SmartSuite, and I'm just gonna put in this is a test. You'll notice that I'm actually writing this in, just as I would inside of any email service provider, inside of my email itself. Well, I'm doing it right here inside of SmartSuite, not leaving the environment. And let's go ahead and send the email. Now, I don't know how long this is gonna take, but we see that right here, it's automatically showing up inside of this, which is really, really cool. And it's saying that we can reply to the email or add a comment. So presumably we could then have a thread, an internal thread inside of SmartSuite, commenting back and forth about an email that isn't necessarily going out externally. So let's go ahead and flip now into my email itself. And I had just received this email, as you see here, 0 minutes ago, came in, said email test from SmartSuite. This is a test. This is exciting. Who does it reply to, I wonder? If I go to reply, it's gonna reply to Gareth at SmartSuite-inbox. I'm really curious to see if this email reply, if I reply here, reply is here. If I reply, is it gonna be automatically brought into my SmartSuite as well? Because that would be next level amazing, right? If interaction with a client or a teammate can happen in email and this person doesn't have to be inside of SmartSuite and it all shows up back here in SmartSuite, that would be crazy cool. Doesn't look like it's brought in just yet, but it could be. It did. It literally did right there as I was commenting about how it didn't come in. The email was replied to, automatically showed up in my communication center, and now, as I was mentioning, I can start a thread here, add people on my team and say, how cool is this? And we can talk about this email communication back and forth. So this is next level incredible. We are able to now send email, start a thread directly inside of SmartSuite, never leave the environment, communicate externally via email that is all automated from SmartSuite, and all of that thread information is gonna be brought right back into our communication center in SmartSuite. This is next level amazing. I can't wait to see what incredible things you are able to build with this. Please test out this feature and let me know what your thoughts are. And if there are parts of it that just blew you away that I forgot to cover here, let me know in the comments below and I will do my best to rectify the situation. I'm not even pretending, I'm pretty stoked about this. So I hope you are too. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to our channel so that you can stay up to date on no-code news just like this. And I will look forward to seeing you in the next video. Woo! I'm losing my voice, folks.